Let's continue using the power rule in this problem. So the next one says square root of x dx. So the square root of x dx. So typically speaking, in this chapter, we don't like radicals. So anytime you see a radical, you're going to need to convert it to a fraction power. In this case, the power is going to be 1 divided by 2, and then dx. Once you do that, you'll be able to use the power rule, which says add 1 to the exponent and divide by the same thing. So let's see, if I add 1 to the 1 half, you can do that in your calculator. How much is 1 half plus 1 going to be? Well, it's going to be 3 halves. And I'm supposed to divide by the same exact thing. Don't forget to write down the plus c. And notice once I add the 1, I no longer write the integral and the dx at the end. Now, x to the 3 half divided by 3 halves, that's the same thing as writing 2 thirds x to the power of 3 half plus c. Let me explain. There's a rule in math that says if you have a fraction divided by a second fraction, then you leave the first fraction alone and you multiply by the reciprocal or the inverse of the second fraction. So that's what I'm doing basically in my case. I have x to the power of 3 half and I can imagine it sitting on top of a 1, and then I have on the bottom a 3 over 2. So when I flip it upside down, it becomes x to the 3 half over 1 times 2 thirds. And this is where the fraction 2 thirds x to the power of 3 half is coming from. The top multiplies with the top, the bottom multiplies with the bottom. And at this point in time, we are basically finished. Okay, so let's see. The next one says 1 over x to the power of 3 dx. So 1 over x cubed dx. Again, another thing that we want in this problem is to avoid having x's on the denominator. Whenever you're doing integrals, you want your x's to be on the numerator. So we're going to have to rewrite the problem as x to the power of negative 3 dx. So it is not convenient to have the x on the denominator. I'm going to bring it to the top by switching the exponent to a negative exponent. And then I can add 1 to the exponent and divide by the same thing. So x to the power of negative 3 plus 1 divided by negative 3 plus 1, and then plus c. By the way, this is the same thing as x to the negative 2 divided by negative 2 plus c. And sometimes people prefer to write this instead, 1 divided by negative 2 x squared plus c. So basically they take the exponent that was negative and they bring it back to the denominator to make everything nice and positive. So far we have two rules to memorize, or two rules to be aware of. If you have a radical in the problem, radicals are not okay. Convert them to fraction power. And if you have x in the denominator, that's not okay either. Convert it to the numerator and add the negative exponent. Okay, so I hope that now that I've told you what the rules are, you can try the next two problems on your own. So pause the video here for a minute and see if you can get these two done. So the first one that you're trying is similar to the square root problem. The second one you're trying is similar to the x cubed that you just did. And here's the solutions to both of those problems. Pause the video and see what you did wrong or what you did right, and let me know if you have any issues.